Hey guys, how are you today? So we are here with Sewing 101, obviously, and we are going to make some little pencil bags today. Now, I know we've already done a pencil bag before. This one's a little different. So this is one of the Michael's Recollections Creative Year Planners that they've come out with recently. Of course, I couldn't resist not long ago buying one. And one of the things I love about it was the fun accessories they have that go along with this, including this pre-punched small zipper pocket that you could put, pencils or washi tape or something in it. And I just, you know, I love the gold dots. And obviously I love the white and gold because that's the one I bought. They also, though, had this pencil bag. And this pencil bag is really fun because not only do you have a small pencil bag here, a zipper pocket, but, and it is lined, by the way, the one, it is lined, it's not, the seams aren't finished. We're not going to line ours, but anyway. It also has a pocket here on the outside, so you can put things inside the zipper part, and you could also stick a couple pens on the outside. The whole thing has elastic. Why? Because you can put it right on your journal cover like that. Who doesn't love that? Now, not long ago when I was at the Japanese dollar store near me, Daiso, I realized they have their own version. It's a little bit smaller and narrower this way and a little shorter. It's only $1.50. The Michael's one was more, but it would work. And it also has the elastic to fit over the journal cover. So I thought maybe for those of you especially who want to make one for yourselves, or you can't afford to go buy one, or you don't have a Japanese dollar store here near you, why don't I show you how to make one? Both of them are nice. I would love this one if I'm flying somewhere because it is smaller and it would force me to limit my supplies I'm bringing, so I have less I'm carrying through the airport. That being said, this one would be more convenient because it's bigger. So I think we're going to make something like this. And we're not going to go too far with this because I might need to take measurements. I have different kinds of fabric here. You're, of course, going to need a sewing machine. You're going to need a sewing machine with, I'm going to put my reading glasses on. You're going to need a sewing machine with a denim needle. You're going to need some fabric. You're going to need some zippers. These are, and I have another one here. Wasn't sure what color I wanted to use, so I have this one. And I think they're all, this one I know is a 7-inch because it's still in the package, but yeah, these are all 7-inch zippers, so I do recommend about a 7-inch zipper. You want some fabric that's going to be kind of on the thick side, like denim. This is denim scraps from some pants I had to hem for myself because, you know, short girl problems, you can't find pants that are the right length. And this is duck cloth. It's an outdoor type fabric and it's kind of thick like denim, so it would work. You also could just use plain canvas or their canvas. This is just canvas and it comes in, you know, plain colors. You can get it printed. Go to the fabric store and look for these kind of fabrics or get out some thicker like denim scraps or something. And I think we're going to make one out of denim and the duck cloth today. So the first thing we're going to do is cut some fabric, and I'm going to move this away. It's really heavy. The duck cloth was only $2.50 for this piece at Hobby Lobby, and I got a quarter of a yard times the width of the fabric, which is about, it's about 45 inches. So that makes a few pencil bags or a small journal cover. All right, so the first thing we want to do is move all our stuff. And you're going to need some elastic. Okay, so the Michael's one. Let's see if I can grab this without bumping the camera. Oops. Okay. Okay, so the Michael's one measures about 7.5 inches by about 2.5 inches. So we're going to cut rectangle that is 8 inches by 6 inches. Yeah. So. I'm going to line up my ruler here with the edge of the fabric. Grab a pencil or other mark making tool. If you have a water soluble, you know, fabric marking pencil, you might want to use that. Okay, well, we'll not use that one because that one has a broken lead. Let's try a different one. Maybe I have one that will actually write. This is a Maped Helix pencil. Love that company. Oh, yeah, that pencil works great. Okay, so I'm going to mark off 2 different places, a few inches apart for 6 inches, and then I can draw a line. Okay. And then cut. Okay. Then I'm going to take this is the finished edge of the manufactured edge of the fabric, which is called the selvage. And I know that's straight and true, so I'm going to line it up with the edge that I just cut. And that will give me a square-ish piece of fabric and tell me which of the short ends is square and true and which one isn't. And the one on my left is square and true. The one on my right is not. So I'm going to take my ruler and line it up with the square edge and then mark off 8 inches. And again, draw a line. Okay. So now we have this piece of fabric, and when we fold it in half, we start to get the idea of the bag, right? Now, the way they did it is they have a fold down here, and that's all well and good, but it makes putting the zipper in a tad on the difficult side. Not impossible, just difficult. Well, different. I shouldn't say difficult. It's different. We're going to try it, but if it's too hard for you, feel free to cut 2 smaller pieces. Than I just did. Leave yourself a little bit of seam allowance on the bottom, and I'll try to show you a way or talk you through a way of putting the zipper in a different way. But try this way first, because I think you might like it. Now, we need a little piece for the outside pocket, so I'm going to fold our main piece in half and bring my fabric back out and line it up here, and again with my pencil mark out. Another rectangle. And it's a little bit too long, but that's okay. I've got lots of this fabric to play with. Now this is just plain old graphite pencil, so it should come out with water. But I'm using very light pencil strokes so that if it shows, I'm not too concerned. And I'm keeping them to the edge so that when I sew the bag, it's not going to show. Okay, so you're going to need these. And I think we're going to be good to go. All right. Let's try it. I haven't done a prototype yet, so we're going to just wing it on camera. And if I screw it up... screw it up. All right, I'm going to change my thread to something that's a cream color, because I have dark blue in here right now, and that's too dark. Throw that away. So first let's take out the bobbin. Whoops. Which tried to roll away. And then I'm going to put either white or cream colored in the bobbin. Ideally, your bobbin thread should match your spool thread in the top. They should match. I don't know if I want to take time to wind a new bobbin. And it looks like the cream colored bobbin doesn't have too much thread on it, but the white one has a ton, so we'll go with the white. That's the wrong way. When you put your bobbin in, if you tug on the thread, it should go clockwise. FYI, there's a little sewing tip. Read your instructions on your machine so you know the proper procedures for threading your machine and which way the bobbin should go in. Oop, thread is stuck. Don't know why. Oh, it's stuck under the machine. That's why. Okay. That's all right. Okay, we'll put the blue one aside. Put the beige one in, cream color. And re-thread my machine. Helps if I turn the light on. Now, your little inexpensive machines are great for practicing your mixed media stuff, like the Janome that I have, but one of my gripes about it is it doesn't have a light bulb. So you might need to put like a little spotlight if you have one of those so you can see what you're doing. Alrighty, now we're all good and threaded. I can close that up. I am going to need my zipper foot, which is in here somewhere. I see it. I see it. Okay, we're going to need the zipper foot. Now, the zipper foot is it looks a little different on each machine. This is the one for my FOF machine. And this side little indentation is where the needle sits so that you can get the foot and the stitching right up close to the zipper teeth. I need to change this back to a straight stitch because I was doing a zigzag earlier for my hemp pants hemming adventure. I think on this one I'm going to use the white zipper. Yeah, first we're going to do the outside pocket. So I don't want it the full length of the zipper pouch, the zipper pouch. I want to have a couple inches shorter. So I'm going to whack off a little less than what I want for the height of the pocket. And then I'm going to hem that top edge. I'm going to roll it and roll it again. And I'm just going to finger press it like that and hold it and stitch it down. Now, if you need to, you can press it or pin it if that works better for you. But I'm just going to finger press it, push it down, roll it twice so that raw edge is hidden, and then put it right side down on the sewing machine. I'm going to line up that top folded edge of the new hem with the edge of the presser foot, and then I'm just going to go back and forth at the beginning and the end. You don't have to go fast, go slow. Okay, and for those of you who are wondering, this is a real-time video. It's not a short one. I'm not going to fast-forward through anything. That doesn't serve you all for a sewing tutorial. So now we have the start of our pocket, right? So I'm going to take our outer fabric, and I'm going to finger press the folded edge so that I have a folded mark where that center point is, which is important. Now I'm going to line up right sides together, the little outside pocket that we just made. I'm lining it up here in this corner along this bottom edge and this side. And then I'm going to flip it over. You might want to pin it. I'm doing this and I'm thinking, you know, I think you need a pin. So I would recommend pinning it. at least once so things don't slide around. All right. So flip it over so you can see that folded part. And then stitch on the fold. When you feel that top of that little pocket, go back and forth a couple times. Now, if you cut your pocket piece correctly, you had about a quarter of an inch that will hang over the fold with which to do this little seam that we just did. If that makes you nervous, not having that much of a seam allowance, then cut this piece a little wider, a little taller. So now, if we take this and we flip it over, now we have the beginnings of a pocket. So now we're going to have our pocket here. Now it's time to put the zipper in. This is the part that makes you all nervous, I know. So the first thing we're going to do is change out our presser foot. And I'm going to put in my zipper foot. Oops. Let's see. There we go. And make sure that the needle is not going to hit the foot. I can adjust the spacing on my needle to be farther to the right or the left if I need to on this machine. And I can go just a little bit towards the right or just a little bit towards the left. Not all machines are you going to be able to do that, but on this particular one I can. So now I'm going to line up my zipper. I'm going to center it here in the along this long edge of the fabric. And I'm going to stick at least one pin in it. Probably two. This is just a random bucket of pins, by the way, if anybody's wondering. Yes, these are corsage pins that I pulled out. It's literally just a random bucket of vintage pins. Some dressmaker's pins, some corsage pins. All right. So now we're going to sew along this part of the zipper. We're not going to get too close to the teeth, because if you get too close to the center of the zipper teeth, then your zipper won't open. You want to be about a quarter to an eighth of an inch away from the zipper teeth. And I need to adjust my presser foot, because my zipper teeth are going to be on the wrong side of that. There we go. Alrighty, now we're ready. I was on the right side to begin with. Oh my goodness. See, you guys are seeing all the issues. Oops. There we go. It's easier to just do this. Okay, that's right about where I want the stitching to go. Now, remember not to sew over your pins. Just go slow. You don't have to go fast. Do go back and forth at the beginning and the end. And flip the zipper over, make sure that you've caught the pocket fabric in your seam, which I have. Make sure your zipper still opens, which it does. Okay, and you want to open it at least part way, because if you don't, you aren't going to be able to get your bag open after we do finish making the bag. So you want to do it, have it this way now. So generally when you use this kind of presser, zipper foot, you have to change it around when you do the other side of the zipper, which is kind of a pain in the neck. There is a different kind of zipper foot that you don't have to do that with, FYI. Okay. I knew there was another piece of string there somewhere. I just couldn't find it. All right, so now we have something that looks like this. Kind of looks like a hot mess, right? it's not really, though. So you can, it's not done yet, but you can turn it right side out. And you can see that now it's starting to look like the zipper pocket, right? So we need to open it back up again. And we need to turn it back out the other way. And now it's time to put the elastic in. So, elastic. So I'm gonna use this other bag as a prototype for how long to cut the elastic. And this one is about that long. It doesn't help you, I know. Hold on. Well, it's about 6.5 inches, 7 inches. I would cut 7 inches. Of course, if you're making this for a larger journal or planner, you may need to cut your elastic a little longer, but you know, it does stretch, so. I do like this little detail they have here on either end of the elastic. So we have these little scraps, right? So we're going to take one of our scraps. And we're going to wrap it around the one of the ends of the elastic. I'm actually going to just whack off a piece here. There we go. So I took a piece that's like 1.5 inches long, and I'm just wrapping it around one end of the elastic. I'm going to fold up the edge, put the elastic in the center, bring one edge over, take the other edge and fold the raw edge over and pull it in. There we go. Make sure all those little ends are tucked in. You don't have to do this. You could sew the elastic right in. I just think this is cute. I'm going to go over it a few times and then cut the threads. And then you're going to have this. You have this hanging open. We want to stitch that closed. So I'm going to make sure it's all folded in together and then just stitch that down. And you notice I haven't changed the foot. It is possible to leave the zipper foot in. I wouldn't necessarily recommend it if you're not used to your machine. So now we have that. That's cute. And just decide whatever side you like prettier, that's prettier, and that's going to be the outside. Whatever you do, though, when you do the other end of the elastic, do it the same way. So I'm going to cut off another hunk of fabric. And do the other end. So that's the stitch where we have it the fabric now wrapped around the elastic. And there's going to be some stress on that, so you want to really go back and forth over it a couple of times. And then I'm going to fix that little hand pressed folded in edge, and I'm going to line it up. Oops, I don't think I held the thread very well, and it got all tangly. Hold on. This is what happens when you don't hold your threads at the beginning of your stitching. You get all these kind of crazy knots. It also can happen if your machine's not threaded correctly. So if you have issues like this, stop, take a deep breath, and check things. For me, I have all this craziness going on down here, so it's all insane. There we go. Ha ha! I already have like a mountain of thread. Okay, let's try that again. That was much better. Okay, so now we have our elastic piece and we have our pocket. So now we need to put our elastic piece inside of our pocket so that it sticks out on one end and it's centered both lengthwise and widthwise. And then I'm going to pin it again with a ginormous corsage pins because it's what I have, so we're going to use it. And then over here, it doesn't have to be perfect. Okay, we're going to double check before we sew. Looks pretty good. So now when you stitch this, we're going to stitch along this edge and stitch it closed. Again, make sure your zipper is open. Pull your zipper teeth so they're up like this. And then we're going to stitch down through everything. And we're just stitching on the little tab end of the zipper. And I'm actually going to change my foot again because it'll be a little easier with the other presser foot on. The regular one. There we go. And I'm just lining up the edge of the fabric with the edge of the zipper foot. And that's giving me about 1/4 inch seam allowance, and that's plenty. Take my pin out. Now, when I get to the part where the elastic is going to be held in, I'm going to go over that a couple of times. Okay. I'm going to trim the edge that's sticking out. I'm going to trim and at a little bit of an angle towards where I stitched. Oops. At a little bit of an angle towards where I stitched to cut off some of the bulk up here. I'm going to trim at an angle going up from the edge of where I stitched right here to trim away a little bit of the bulk in the corner. And then I'm going to just do a quick little zigzag along that edge. To provide some stay stitching power so that the fabric doesn't like unravel all over the place. Okay, now let's do the other side. Again, lining up the edge of the fabric with the edge of the foot. Whoops. Straight stitch. Whoops. Okay, back and forth. Pull the pin out. String, because you know there's strings now everywhere on my table. All right, cut off the threads, cut all the loose crazy threads off. I'll try to show it now on camera. See this part sticking out? Cut that off. See right here where you have all this sticking out and the stitching is right there? So I'm going to have my scissors angled so that they're like an eighth of an inch away from the stitching, but facing up. And I'm going to cut a bunch of this bulk off. I think that just went into my paint water. And I'm going to do something similar over here and cut some of this corner off on this end. But don't be careful, don't cut your stitching. Okay. I think that went in my paint water. Oh, well. Now, again, we're going to do the zigzag here. The zigzag's optional, you don't have to do that. All right, so now we're ready to see how it looks. So I'm gonna start with the bottom corner and I'm gonna push it out. And then the upper one. You might need a tool to help you poke all the corners out. Now, if you don't trim some of that zipper, extra zipper away, then it won't poke out as nice as if you do chop it off. Look at that. We have a pencil pouch. That is super cute. I love it. So if you use a stiffer fabric, than even this, or you add interfacing to it, it'll be more like this one. See, this one's a little bit floppy, and that's just because there's nothing in it. I'm okay with that. I love this fabric, but look. Cute! And let's see how it fits on the journal. So once you get it on the journal and you get pencils in it, it's going to be fine. So isn't that cute? And then you can stick... pencils here, stuff inside the pouch. I love that. So there you go. Should we make another one? Put my pen away. So I think I'm going to make some more of these because they are super cute. And you can use anything. You can use extra denim. You can use fabric that you have laying around, anything. If you're using fabric like this denim, this is stretchy, so it's probably not the best choice. That being said, if you can get it to work, it might be nice because it is stretchy. You can probably, if you can cut it the right way, get it to stretch so you can get even more stuff in the pencil bag. So I think I'm going to make some more of these, but I hope it gives you some ideas of what you can do in making your own pencil bag to fit right on your journal or your planner. So I hope this is something that gives you some great ideas. Don't forget that in my Facebook group and the sister groups, we have the year of my life of self-expression 2017 journaling program coming up. That revolves around really just being mindful of ourselves, taking care of ourselves, documenting our life, and taking it with us when we go places. I use mine as a, not only a, everyday documentation kind of thing, or every, month, but I also take it with me when I go out of town. And this kind of little pencil bag would be perfect on these planners. We're going to have monthly lessons and hints and tips and tricks, but you only get them if you're over in the Facebook group. So you have to join one of the Facebook groups. My group is in the description below, and this little pocket would be great on your journals. So give it some thought, and I hope you have fun with it. If you have any questions, let me know. Send me an email or a private message or make a comment below. Think about supporting my channel by shopping in the Etsy shop and or buying a signed copy of my book or pre-ordering some of the new stamps. And that's it for today. Go out and have a great day. Do something nice for yourself because you deserve it. And I'll see you later. Bye, guys.